Hello and welcome to episode 3 Timberborn Beginner's Guide. Today I'll talk about districts, how to build them, extend them and how to transfer items between districts, because that's what many people struggle with initially. Let's start. Here we go, I did some things beforehand, like the water wheels, some paths, some stairs, also 4 warehouses. Plus 4 warehouses in the background, especially this one, which is for berries, and this one for carrots, so we have enough food in our storage. And a quick shortcut. As you can see here, if you wonder how this is working, it's just like paths underwater, so they can travel and swim to the other side. Okay, today, as I said, we will talk about districts mainly, but the last episode I said we will also place the gear workshop. Needs 100 science points and 25 blanks. So we will place this down. Okay, research it, place it here, and that's all you need to do. These two need 50 each. Boss power, or as I say it, beaver power. And this one 120. And each water wheel delivers 180, so it's fine. Okay, so how do districts work? As you have seen in the last episode, if we extend this path, the build range is also extended, but only to some degree. Here it ends, actually, if we place it a little bit longer. You can see it ends here. If I place a building down here, it won't be built. Even if you get yourself under labor the builder's hut. Yes. If I place this down here, it won't be built. And if I place this builder hut here and place another building outside of the district range, it also won't be built. So how can we do that? Let's say, let's get rid of this. It bothers me. Okay. Let's say we want to have a district up here because we want to build a dam on this side so we have even more water to survive from. We go to paths and structures. Place the path along this way. And then we check the border range of the old district. So it ends here. We click on this, delete the path, and go to district gate. And as the description is telling you already, separates districts. This is important because if I place down a district here and want to connect it with a path directly to the old district, it won't let you do that. So place your district gate then to the district center. And as we said in the last episode also, it's roughly one screen away the range of the district. So I place this and lay down my path like this. Okay, some stairs, so they can reach this. And now you're asking yourself, yeah, but wait, how can they build these? If they can reach the stairs to build them, they will, clearly. You can see it happening right now. But this is the end of the district range. So, this can't be built, so it isn't connected. And how do we get beavers to the other district? That's no problem at all. If you click on the old district, you have a button which is named Migrate Population. As you can see, we need huts on the new district, and also some food and some water. Or they just do their own thing, their own water and own wood. But yeah, you need to plan this, because if we don't have resources up here or don't have them beforehand, your beavers will die of course. So, what we are gonna do is we go again to not storage. I always forget the icon for it. Icon storage labor. Ah, it's labor in the English menu. We have a distribution post and they distribute goods to other districts. And we have a drop-off point. This one receives goods from other districts. So 250 research points. We get this. Yeah, we replace it here. Why not? Distribution post, 250 research points. We will also get this. And this one we place here. One problem is all the warehouses are on this side. And here's the distribution post. And they need to carry all the stuff from here, from all our storages, up to here. And we have only two unemployed in the old district, which is okay. I will pause the slumber flag checks we have. And actually gather a flag. We have enough food. And this lumberjack flag for now. So we have six unemployed. Now we go towards the distribution post again, and as you can see, four are working here already. They have 100 plus strength percent, which means they can haul double the amount of the normal beavers. Okay, and now how do we get the resources from here to here? It's no problem at all. You just click on the distribution post and say add a new route. You select this, choose the drop-off point, and now select the things you want to haul, which you can only do one at a time. So we need food. I say berries, please haul berries. Also, some routes are not functioning because of the stairs. We will fix this soon. Now say add a new route. Also, we want logs. And water. Water is important. Okay. How do we get this wooden stairs built? Yeah. That's the problem. We can now get... There's two ways. You can place the distribution post on the same level. And we get a path here. And after this thing is built, we changed, delete this and get it again up here. Because I want it there. Or you just create another district. Yes, we can delete this. Again, go to district center. Then district gate. And you can see it fits right in. It should have the range to build this. Plus, we first need to get rid of this path and this district gate. So this path gets connected to this district now. And you can see it extends the range. It does extend the range. We get a new drop-off point. Labor drop-off point. And again, add a new route. And we want to deliver logs, and as you can see that they directly start their work. Just click pause for a moment. What you also can do, and what you should do, is if you click on this distribution post, you can see there's district distribution limits. Click these, and now you have low amounts and high amounts. The low amount, those tell you don't haul things if your stock goes under this value. So if we want to have always minimum 200 berries in this district, just put 200 down here. So we always have something in stock. also I say carrots, logs, you can do this with every, yeah, with every good. Obviously planks, I want 20. And water minimum 300 because it's a large district already compared to the new ones. Okay. And what is coming in the future? Gears 15. Okay. That's enough for now. Let them do their work. And now we will migrate two beavers to adults. Of course, children can't work. And they should be... Oh, I've chosen the wrong one. District 4, migrate. Okay, now they... From here... They traveled to this district. No houses, they will sleep on the ground. But it's no problem for now. Now you can see he is already carrying the goods to this stairs. But we need planks. Did we select planks? New route. Deliver planks for the stairs. Okay. You can skip this if you want. I will later mark it in the video. Okay, now it's built. So I delete this and also delete this. Delete district gate. That wasn't necessary. But it's okay. Let's check the borders again. There's the border. District gate. Connect paths again. And now we are here. Now they can reach it. And we water logs and berries we have selected already. They should be, yeah, they should drop off the goods here soon. And yeah, that's for the drop off point and distribution post. What you can't do is get goods from this district to this one. If you want to do this, you need the same on this district. So you go again to labor, to the distribution post, place it in this district. Okay, and then we need another drop-off point in the old one. Just like this. And then if this is finished, you need to again, you need to set your routes and goods again for this drop off point. That's all about districts. Wasn't that hard? Thank you very much for watching. If you have ideas for guides for beginners, let me know. Write your suggestions and questions in the comments. If you want to subscribe, subscribe. If you want to leave a like, leave a like. Helps me out a ton. And thank you very much for your support. I appreciate it. Have a nice day. Bye.